Everything started from this old wall clock. First of all, I took it apart. Next, I started sanding with a grinder. As you can see, it is made out of MDF. To sand the curved parts, I used this bit. And some hand sanding for difficult spots. Here I mark the area I had to remove to fit the tuning pegs. Next, I used a router with a straight bit to remove the material. I completed this procedure with two passes. I sanded the router marks with a grinder. Then I added the guidelines to help me shape the neck. I started removing material with a flat rasp. In curved areas, I used the round rasp. Here I clean the rasp marks using the file. And I finish with 100 grit sandpaper. The grinder was pretty aggressive, so I used my random orbit sander to even things out. Next, I used a long sanding block to flatten the area that would receive the fretboard. The block is just a leg from an IKEA table. I attached the sandpaper with double-sided tape. That worked out really nicely. Next, I filled these holes with 8mm dowels. I cut the dowels flush and sanded with the rotary tool. The pickup holder was made out of plywood. I removed most of the material with a Forstner bit. Some chisel work here, and I actually remade it a little bit larger. Here I finished shaping with the rotary tool. And it fitted nicely. Next, I glued the pickup holder in place. Here I cut the excess on the bandsaw and I sanded it flush. I also created a roundover on the edges. Using a Forstner bit, I opened the hole for the potentiometer. And it fits nicely. The cables of the electronics will be placed in a groove. I created the groove with my router. The groove was completed with two passes. Here I route the space for the jack. The jack plate was made out of copper. Here I score the copper sheet with a knife. And here I break it off. Next, I drilled the necessary holes. I used the file to grind over the edges. Here, I bent it to shape. Next, I drilled the tuning peg holes. I decided to remove this area so I can reach the higher notes better. I removed the material on the banjo. And I used the file to adjust the shape. Now let's talk about how I made the fretboard. First of all, I jointed one side of the wood. Then I flattened the other side. And I had two flat sides perpendicular to each other. Next, I passed the piece through the thickness planer. Here I cleared the edges on the table saw. Using a rasp, I shaped one edge of the fretboard. I cleaned the rasp's marks with a file, and I finished with sandpaper. I also rounded over the edges on the belt sander. The scale of my instrument is 51 cm from nut to bridge. Using an online fret calculator, link in the description, I found the fret positions. First, I marked the fret positions. Then I carefully cut the slots on my miter box. It is important to use a saw that creates a slot in which your fret wire will fit snugly. Next, I use the punch to mark the fret position indicators. I cut a slot on the banjo for the nut. The nut is made out of plexiglass. Here, I temporarily clamped the fretboard in place and drilled two 6mm holes. Next, to glue the fretboard. The two holes will not only be indicators, but they also hold the fretboard from sliding around while glued up. Finally, I added my clamps and used a wet rag to clean up the excess glue. When the glue dried, I added the rest of the indicators. I then cut the dowel's flash. I used a piece of paper as a seam so I wouldn't hurt the fretboard. And a little bit of sanding. As you can see, I messed up the headstock. So I added a plywood piece. This will strengthen the headstock a little. I cut it a bit oversized, just to be safe. And I glued it in place. A few more clamps never hurt anybody. While the glue dried, I decided to modify the jack plate. After I cleaned the pieces, I added flux. Here, I solder a little cap on my jack plate. I filed the excess material. And I sanded it flush. It came out pretty cool. Back to the headstock. I sanded it flush with my rotary tool. Here, I mark the center hole from behind and I drill to expose the center from the other side. Now, I can create a clean cut hole. I decided to remove material from behind so the jack moves freely. Time to add the frets. I cut the fret wire to size and hammered the frets in place. I secured the frets with a drop of super glue. Next, I filed the frets flush. I cleaned the file marks with a sanding block. I tilted the sanding block to add a little bevel on the frets. This makes them better and safer to the touch. I wanted to leave some imperfections exposed, so I did not get crazy with sanding. Next, I used my wood burner to add fret indicators to the side. I named my guitar Clocky to kind of honor the original item. Here, I have increased the heat so the pyrographer writes better. Finally, I applied the first coat of water-based clear varnish. I sanded between coats with 220 grit. I applied 3 coats in total. Next, I applied primer to the jack plate. And I painted it black. Moving on to the electronics. First, I added the flux. Then, I coated all the joints with solder. This wire stripper is a really cool tool to have. I connected everything temporarily and tested the pickup. I just hit the pickup with a metal object. I used this wiring diagram from Seymour Duncan's website. It's for one humbucker and one volume pot. I'll put a link in the description. Next, I screwed the pickup in place. I used heat shrinking tube and hot glue to keep everything nicely organized. The air gun helps cool the hot glue a bit faster. Here, I screwed the plate in place. I finished the fretboard with my homemade beeswax and mineral oil paste. Here, I installed the tuning pegs. Next, I pre-drilled pilot holes and screwed the string guides in place. I used rivet heads as string holders. I shaped the nut and bridge from a piece of plexiglass. Next, to make the bridge. I cut the plexi on the banjo. I clamped the nut and bridge together. Using a V-shaped file, I opened the slots for the strings. And I glued the bridge pieces. This is a ready-made knob for the volume. I added strings to see what fine tunings I had to do. I had to add screws as string guides to keep the strings in the slots. I raised the pickup to increase its volume. To level the frets, I masked the fretboard and marked their peaks. Then I sanded the frets flat. As you can see, some frets were higher than others. Here I polished the frets with steel wool. I should have used fret files first, but I don't have any. I have also added a screw to keep the bridge secure. Finally, I sanded the bones a little bit to reduce the action of the strings. The setup of the instrument still needed work, but I ran out of time and decided to stop here for now. The instrument actually turned out much better than I expected it.
Thank you.